Welcome to Programming with Qt Widgets. I'm Jesper Pedersen from QTopia. You just landed in the second module of Programming with Qt Widgets. And in this module, we'll talk about Qt Designer. So what is Qt Designer? Well, Qt Designer is a tool for you to graphically drag and drop your user interface together. We saw in the previous module that you could create your user interfaces by writing C++ code, and that is possible still, but in 98% of the time, you just want to drag and drop them together inside of Qt Designer. That's exactly what we'll see in this episode. Obviously, you want to connect that code to some C++ backend code that you have, and that's what we'll focus on in the next episode. Following that, we'll talk about layout inside of Qt Designer. We'll talk more about how you connect C++ code to Qt Designer code, to the UI you created in Qt Designer. Then we'll talk about accelerators, that's pressing Alt E, for example, to exit, or some similar things, and tab order. We will talk about custom widgets. How do you get your own widgets into Qt Designer? So you've created a compass or something like that, and you want that visually inside of Qt Designer. And finally, I've dedicated an episode of giving you pointers to Qt widgets and more, where I have lots of episodes talking about Qt Designer. But to make it possible for you to follow along, I'll start entirely from scratch. So, file, new projects. And what I want is a Qt widgets application. I'll do that. I'll put it in my home directory and let's call it editor. Which build system do I want? Well, I can choose between CMake and QMake. And if you're starting a new project, QMake is the easier one initially, but CMake is better for the long run. So we'll go with CMake. Then it will ask me for a class that you'll create inside of Qt Designer, actually, main window, and what is the class name, what's the base class, the header file, so on. And yes, that all seems very reasonable. I likely want my main window to be called main window, so that's cool. Do I want some translation support? Not right now. We can add that later on if we want. And finally, which Qt version do I want? Let's just take the desktop Qt 5.15 here. It does not really matter for this presentation. I could have taken the 6.5.1 or any of the other versions of Qt that I have installed. And finally, do I want some project management? Should this project be part of another project that I could choose it in here? And should I have some version control? And yeah, well, I likely would like to have Git. So it will add these files over here for me. I'll say finish, and now I'm ready to go. It start out telling me something about Git that's, well, it's adding those files to my Git repository. Okay, we are up and running. We got a very first project, and hey, let's even try and run it right away. Control R for run. It's building, and here is my main window. Does not look like very much, but hey, that's because I haven't done much to it either. If you look in the sidebar over here, you can see that my editor now has a main.cpp, expectedly. It has a main window cpp and a main window.h. That's the C++ part of the user interface that, for the main window. And it has a main window.ui. And if I select this one, I'll go into this view here, which is Qt Designer embedded inside of Qt Creator. You can run Qt Designer yourself. If you're using some IDE that does not embed it, then you can run the standalone designer application, but we have it in here. What we see here is, well, first this site here is from Qt Creator, and up here is this toolbar is from Qt Creator, and in here from this pixel and down to the corner is Qt Designer. This is the list of all the different widgets we have inside of Qt Designer, and if I scroll far enough down, you'll see a bunch with this green K in front of it. They are from my own projects where I have plugins for Qt Designer. We'll talk about that a bit later. Then we have the main area here, that's where I'll be doing my design. Over here, we have the object browser. That's how I can see the parent-child relationship of my objects. And it's not that often that I need it, but sometimes I need to select a specific one, sometimes to worry around problems with dumping stuff into the right layout. And finally, down here, we have our property editor, and we'll talk much more about that in just a minute. Given that I'm recording this, so you can somewhat see it on a cell phone, I am recording this. It's in super small resolution, which you usually wouldn't do. So let's just ask this window here, the signal slot editor, to go away, so we'll get just a wee little bit more screen real estate. As the project name indicated, and I might even have told you, but that would be a few minutes ago and I cannot be expected to remember so far back, I am going to create an editor, a very simple editor. So let's start out by going over here in the sidebar and find something that would be a good widget for an editor. It can sometimes be difficult to find it, but the names here of the groups, it's not a layout, it's not a space, buttons. Is it an item view? No, those are the trees and the tables and so on. And here are the widget based of those trees and tables. Is it container? Getting closer. It's definitely an input widget. So we have a few different ones here. Let's just take the plain text editor. I'll press down, I will drag it over, and here it is in my use interface. And I can already now look what it looks like in the final production code by going to Tools, Form Editor, and Preview, Alt, Shift, R. That's a good key combination to remember. Here it is. It's what my use interface looks like. But also observe that if I resize it, it doesn't really resize all that well. And by now, you likely know exactly what I did wrong. I forgot to add a layout manager. Can I have your focus over here on the sidebar? Notice especially this here is a QWidget that do not have a layout manager associated to it. So if I choose that one, that's my topmost widget that I have up here. Now I need to add a layout manager. You might be tempted at going over here and choosing one of these, but these are actually widgets with layout managers built in. We'll see that in a few episodes. What I want up is one of those up here, namely a layout manager that I add to the selected widget. There we are. Now I chose a horizontal layout manager, and if Alt Shift R review again here, I will be able to notice that now it scales just perfectly well. You want to do what? Pay money for training? Can't you just find something on YouTube? I know these Qt people, they put out all kinds of different things on YouTube. Well, we also do have scheduled trainings, and trust me, it's a complete different dynamic. I suggest that you check out our list. We haven't yet talked about what a main window is, but think of Microsoft Word. There, the editor with the toolbars and menu bars and so on is your main window. And for that purpose, we need to add some toolbars and menu bars to our main window too. So let's do that. Up here at the top, it says type here. And what I can do is type file. That will give me an entry in the menu bar for file. And well, what do we want in here? Maybe save and load. And let's get a separator in here. There we are. Now we can see a separator. And let's type quit. And Alt Shift R. You can see that I now have my file menu, save, load, and quit. Of course, it doesn't do anything, but we'll see that in the next episode. One thing that is nice up here is if I get this working. I cannot get that working. I'll go over here then. See, when I have my menu bar, you can see that in the sidebar for the Objects Explorer. Menu bar, menu file. If I choose this one, then I can go down here and scroll a bit down. It's slightly difficult to find because of the resolution. Down here it says file, and I can change that property, ampersand. If I put an ampersand in front of it, you see that it got an underscore there. And that, well, it's got to be somewhat difficult to show up here. But if I press Alt F now, it opens up that menu. And similar, I could do the same thing. And that's what I tried to do up here. And I can do it for save. I can just double click here on save and ampersand in front of save and in front of load. Or maybe load needs to have it under the O. I don't know why I would want that. And of course, quit like this. So now I can operate my menus by running FQ to Alt F to get that up and Alt Q now to execute the quit action. Let's do a small exercise here. A mental one. Imagine you were to create a class for a person in C++. Not anything, nothing Qt designer, just a regular C++ class. What would its constructor look like? Yeah, I guess so too. You would create a constructor with at least one argument, namely the name of the person. Now imagine that you had that in the sidebar over here in Qt designer. We don't. So we'll take a push button instead. I'll take the push button here, I'll drag it in. How do I specify the constructor argument for, say, the text of the push button? Well, I don't. Instead, when I've dragged it in, I can choose the widget either by just clicking on it or choosing it up here in the Object Explorer, and then I can specify properties on that object. And let me just give you a few examples here. Let me just make this slightly larger so we can see what's going on here. We have our main window. That's what I selected up here. We can see that's the class main window, it's the object main window because it has an object name. We'll get back to that a bit later also. And it's a subclass of QMainWindow. And this is what will be generated whenever you generate the C++ code for this form, but we'll see that a bit later. I can scroll down. Here are all the properties of QObjects, because QMainWindow is subclassing. Let's scroll down. QMainWindow is subclassing QWidget, which is subclassing QObjects. So I have them sorted in here. Now, scrolling down, and let me just Alt-Shift-Run before we do that. You notice that it says main window dash preview dash dash Qt creator. Preview dash Qt creator here comes from Qt creator adding that itself, but the title here, main window, is what I'll see in my running application. And for that, if I scroll down, I will be able to find here window title. That's a property of that object. I can change it here to say power editor. And now when I run my application, or I previewed inside of Qt Designer here, then I can see that it says Power Editor. In the main window, we had a toolbar, we had a menu bar, we had a status bar, and we already populated our menu bar. But the way that underneath the encode, the what menu bars are populated with are instances of the class QAction. QAction is this pretty nice encapsulation. It's a title of the action, that's a property on it. It has the image. If it's on a toolbar, then you can see that image, or if you've chosen to see images in the menu bar, you can do that too. You can set the shortcut for it. You can change a lot of different properties on it. Let's try and configure one of those actions, namely the quit action. So if I choose file quit, you can see over here in my Object Explorer that I actually chose action quit. And now I have action quit as it says here or here. And here are the properties of that. And you can see that the text is ampersand quit. If I had an icon, then I could specify that icon here. If I scroll down, I could make it visible. So I could have an action that wasn't shown all the time, possibly. But also I have a shortcut. Let's try and change the shortcut here. So press the shortcut, Control Q, and now I got a shortcut for quit. And I was just about to say, let me show you that in action, but still that is not connected up, but we'll see that in a second. A bit more a second, depending on whether you're watching this more or less live, because then it's going to be tomorrow, but otherwise in the next episode. Let's see one more property here. So I have the main window again, and as you saw, my main window has the object here, QObjects superclass, QWidgets superclass, And sometimes I want to do stuff up here, and sometimes I want to go down and just look at these, the specific subclass that I have in mind. It depends on where the information is. And imagine that my text editor should start out in read-only mode. Then I could just click here, and now Alt-Shift-R. I can no longer get my points, my text edit here to accept input, and just so that you see that it actually did before. Now you can see that I can type stuff in here. The line wrap mode, wonder what that is. Well, that's a cool thing about doing this from within QCreator, F1, and here is the documentation for what line wrap mode is all about. What's this? My eyes bleeds. That's looks like XML. Wasn't that something like from the 90s? What is that? Well, this is what the UI files, you can see up here, mainwindow.ui. This is actually what it looks like. And I can not edit it. It's in read-only, and I likely do not want to do that. So I can right-click here. I can see open with form editor. Okay. And now I'm back looking at it. But sometimes, for example, by pressing escape, I end up here. What is the far easiest is just to press Control Tab, which will get me to something else. Control Tab again will get me back. And now I'm back. So whenever I'm here, it's just Control Tab, Control Tab, and I'm back into that view. If for some reason, and I'm not even going to give you an example, but if for some reason you had a need, well, you could go up here, right click, open with plain text editor. And now we are actually able to change stuff here. So make it only 200 pixels wide width of the width. We'll save it. So otherwise it'll likely ask me to, and go back to the form editor. And now I have a very narrow editor in here. So I can edit those XML files. And the reason why there are XML files is that that makes it easier for you to have them in Git. And even if one person were changing the spelling error in the menu, another person was adding something there, Git would know how to merge these XML files and likely be able to do that without any errors most of the time. I already hinted at you that you could have your actions both on the toolbar and on the menu bar. So let me show you that I can put my quit action on the toolbar too. So I choose the action quit over here. Let me give it an icon, otherwise it doesn't look like much. I'll type real fast, document open here. That is an icon that comes from the theme that Qt picked up on my computer. So it might not even be on your computer if you try that at home. But I'll talk much more about resources much later in this video series here. Now I got the icon. I want it on my toolbar, so I'll choose Add Toolbar. I have a toolbar over here. But to be able to get that action on, I need to go view. So I need to get that action editor back in. And here you can see my action quit. Drag it up here to be, go away. Drag it up here, not hitting the menu bar, just the toolbar. And I could even get the load action up here too. It doesn't have an icon, but Alt-Shift-R. And you can see I got my quit action here. Still doesn't do anything. Isn't that annoying? Well, stay tuned. In the next episode, we will see how we connect our user interface to some C++ code. Until then, have a great time.